Hi guys, welcome back to another video. I hope you're all doing really well. I thought today I would pick the camera up because I'm starting a little mini glow up because I have been feeling so groggy and drained and I think I'm just completely burnt out. I feel like the last few videos that I've started have all been started with me moaning, so I really don't want that to come across wrong, and I don't want to come across as like a moany, moody, mardy cow all the time. But I think I've just burnt myself out basically, and my body is starting to show it. I feel really run down. Me and Sam have actually been completely in the wars this weekend. It's now Sunday, 1:45. And we've had like a really slow chilled out Sunday morning, but this weekend we've literally not done anything because Sam is pretty much bedridden. He has pulled all of his back at the gym, so he's literally been immobile. He's not been able to get up. Like, even just getting up out of bed is like a massive mission for him, so he's been really struggling. So I've obviously been doing all the bits around the house, and we've just not been able to get out and do anything this weekend, which, first world problems, I know. But I've also felt really groggy and run down. I don't know if I've got like a virus type thing. I just feel really drained. I feel a bit flu-like. So we're gonna start a little mini glow up session. I don't know what to call it, a mini glow up, because I feel like how I feel on the inside is reflecting on the outside. What is my hair doing? Honestly, like, it's not it. Look at my nails. So I need to do my nails. I've also booked in for a facial. I think that's on Tuesday, so I thought I could bring you along to that as well, because obviously I've mentioned in previous videos that I get skin peels for my acne, and my acne is still not gone anywhere, to be honest. It is settling down, but still not great. So we've booked him for another appointment to get my skin done. Just gonna have a bit of time out to have some self-care, some pampering. I feel like this always kind of makes me feel a bit better when I need it. And I actually posted a TikTok the other day saying that I felt really drained and tired and run down. And I had some comments from people who like work from home saying that they get the exact same. And obviously I feel completely blessed and so lucky to work from home. But I think working from home, you do get kind of stuck in a rut, and it can make you feel really like drained and groggy, like a zombie. So I find that these little mini self-care sessions just perk me up and refresh me and make me feel a bit better. So first up in this little glow up, we need to do these nails. Look how grown out they are. They've also really broken and chipped. Last time I did them, I did like a rounded oval shape, you can kind of see. But I don't think that's great for my nails because a few of them have completely broke and kind of gone like squared off at the ends. I don't know if you can see that there. So I thought we could sit and do my nails together and I'll show you kind of how I do it. I think I've done this in a video before, but I absolutely love doing my own nails. I love the kit that I've got. It's so good and it's such good value for money as well. So if you're interested in obviously starting to do your own nails, then I'll show you the kit that I've got and the bits and bobs that comes with it and how I do mine. Obviously not a nail tech, not a professional, have just kind of learned from videos and by doing it myself, but I've never had any issues with this kit and I absolutely love it. I actually got my mum one as well and I put her on it because obviously getting your nails done is so expensive and my nails grow so quickly. So when I was getting my nails done at the salon, I was paying like £30-40 every 2 weeks and it just soon adds up. So I think if you can learn to do it yourself, it's so much better, because I also get so fidgety and bored sat in the nail salon, which is going to sound so bizarre because I know to most women that's like their time of relaxation, but I get so restless and fidgety. So when I'm doing it myself, it's kind of therapeutic because it gives me something to do. It's like that kind of mindless activity. I put something on the telly and just chill. So yeah, that is the objective of this little video. We're gonna have a little glow up together. It'll probably be throughout the week because I also need to sort my hair out. I need to put a hair mask in. I haven't already got a hair mask in, even though it looks like my hair could be drenched in oil because it is that greasy. So we can do a little hair care routine, skincare routine, nails, obviously my facial appointment as well. And I just thought it'd be fun to kind of show you the products that I love using at the moment and my little sort of self-care glow up routine when I'm feeling a bit groggy, or I just feel like I need a little bit of a pick-me-up and a little bit of a refresh. So we are in the living room on the sofa, all nice and cozy. I'm gonna get myself a drink, and I've got my little nail tray. I've literally popped this kit on a tray that so that I can move it around the house wherever I'm sat, and I'll show you what I've got in it. So excuse the absolute state of it, I do need to sort this out and kind of organize what I need and what I don't need and kind of hide it and organize it, because it's just obviously a hot mess at the moment. But this is the brand of the kit that I use, and I actually got it off of Amazon, and it was a really good kit. It was about, I want to say, about £35, and you got the lamp, you got like loads of accessories, so like little gems, little nail files, cuticle oil, clippers, all that kind of thing. Oh my god, this tray is actually a mess, I'm so sorry. And then you got all of these colours, which are just right up my street. I've actually made myself my own little like colour chart, like you get in the salon and you can sit and pick your favourite colour. They're not all on there. I ordered a few extra colours as well that weren't initially in the kit. And then obviously you get like your base coats and your top coats, and then I've just got a nail varnish remover. This is actually like a micellar water pump. I've just put it in there because it's easier for me to use it when it's like that. And then I've got some cotton wool. I need to go and grab the tin foil because I need to obviously soak these monstrosities off. But yeah, I think I'm gonna give this a tidy and an organize, because as you can see, it is not looking cute at the moment. But yeah, I will try and link that kit if I can, because it's such good value for money. As I've said, I think I've linked it in some previous videos before, because I do get quite a lot of questions about it, because I always post it on TikTok and stuff like that, because it's just 10 out of 10, cannot fault it. So I'm gonna go and get myself a drink now, and then we will start on the soak off process. It is quite a long process, but once you get into it, it's fine and it's so worth it. First step of the nail removal process is literally getting a file. I use, where is it? I used this one. I don't know where this came from, to be honest. I think my mum actually gave it to me, so I'm not sure if you can pick this brand up on Amazon, but it takes off the top coat of the gel so quickly and easily because it's quite coarse. So I'll just gently buff the shiny top coat of the gel, which is obviously the top coat, and then I will cut one of these cotton pads into quarters and then soak each quarter in some nail varnish remover, and then wrap my finger up in tin foil with the cotton pad on top of the gel polish, and it just goes really soft after like 15 to 20 minutes. And then included in that kit that I got from Amazon was this like cuticle pusher backer like scraper tool, and I use that to just gently push off the gel. But by the time you soaked it for that long, it's so soft anyway, it just kind of melts off, so you don't have to really scrape your nail or anything, which is good because I don't want to cause any damage to my nails, because these are my natural nails. I don't put any extensions or anything on them, and I found that this kit actually helps my nails grow so much because it makes them really hard and strong. So yeah, I'm gonna go and get myself a Dr. Pepper, I think. Okay, so I've just filed them down to about that. I don't know if you can really see. But I really just try and get like the top shiny coat off so that they look matte pretty much. The more that you get off filing it, the less scraping that you have to do. But obviously you've got to balance it, because you don't want to start filing your natural nail. So after that, just get some kitchen foil is what I usually do. And then cut some squares, probably about this big, I'm going to say, just enough to like wrap around your finger and secure down the cotton wool. So I usually get like 3 squares off of one strip. So obviously I'll cut enough for each finger, and then show you what I do. And then obviously I get my little cotton wool pad, like I said earlier, and I usually cut this into like quarters so that it's big enough to sit on the nail. And then I get my little pump of nail varnish remover and just push it down so it's nice and soaked in that. And then I just pop it over the nail like that. Take a piece of the tin foil, wrap it round and secure it down so it's like that. And then I can just sit with my nails soaking for like 10 to 15 minutes so it goes nice and soft.
Okay, update. We went for like a square coffin shape. I've pushed back all my cuticles. All the gel is removed, so we are ready to start painting them. While I was soaking my nails, I actually filled in this little like chart that came with the kit that you can then peel these stickers off and stick them on the bottles so that you know what colour's which, because these labels on the top look completely different to the actual colour. So like, for example, where is it? I think this one is actually that one. So you can see that they look completely different. I think that might be the colour that I'm going to go for, this one here. Because it's like a nice nudie, but it's still like a lilac-y, summery type vibe. So these are the nails, all nice and fresh and finished. I'm literally standing near our back door so you can get a better view of them, but I absolutely love them. They're obviously plain Jane because I never go for anything too extravagant, but I'm absolutely loving them. They feel so much better and so much fresher.
So it's a couple of days later. I didn't actually pick my camera up yesterday when I went to go and get my skin peel, but there wasn't really much to show. I've had a few skin peels before and I've spoken about it over my TikTok and I've actually filmed a video all about it, but the peeling hasn't started just yet. I have got a bit of purging already on my chin, so I've got some like juicy whiteheads brewing, which is just so attractive and absolutely love that. But what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna have a hair wash, I'm gonna have like a full body shower. So I thought I'd show you some products that I love to use and also my little hair care routine. You can see how greasy my hair is and how desperate it is for a wash. So I'm gonna do like a mask, like a shave, exfoliate, that kind of shower, you know what I mean. I've just made myself a coffee, I've just got back from my walk. I've been trying to do this every morning. I felt really rough the last week or so though, so it's kind of slipped. So I'm trying to get back into it again, but I feel so much better for doing it. So we're gonna have a coffee. We're gonna have an everything shower and I'm gonna show you the products that I've been loving using at the moment. I think most of them are in the shower, so I'll go and grab them. So products wise and hair wise, every single week without fail, I will use a hair mask, but I like to kind of alternate what hair mask I use each week. And to be fair, I only wash my hair about once a week, maybe twice a week if I've got plans. So I alternate between these Coco and Eve ones. This one, like a virgin, it leaves your hair so silky smooth. It's really good if you've got like bleached, dry hair. This is really good for the summer, I think, as well, because I feel like my hair does get naturally drier when the sun's on it. And then this one, Sweet Repair, kind of the same vibes. I think this one's got like hyaluronic acid and stuff like that. So I think this is like a deeper repair. So this actually works. Like, I kind of want to say like Olaplex. I don't think it's got like the same technology as Olaplex, but I think it works deeper to like restore your hair, whereas this one makes it look and feel softer and shinier, if you get what I mean. This is more for like the general health of your hair. I think I'm gonna go for the Sweet Repair today. And then, so I alternate between those two, and I've also been loving oiling my hair, and I used to do this all the time when I was younger. Before like hair masks became like a proper fad, probably when I was like 15, 16, I would slather my hair in raw coconut oil, and it really, really helps the health of it, and it helps to grow it as well. Like when my hair was the longest it's ever been, it's because I was oiling it every week. So I'll probably do this like once every 2 to 3 weeks and alternate between the three of the hair masks. And then shampoo and conditioner wise, I'm gonna be totally honest, I don't really have like a strict routine with it. At the moment, I'm just using one from Lidl, which I know a lot of you will be cringing at. But I don't kind of have like a strict routine with that, and I like to shampoo twice. So I do religiously use this Redken one for my bleach. It's obviously like a toner purple shampoo. It's really good. This one doesn't dry your hair out, and that's probably one of the best
purple shampoos I've used. And then for conditioner, sometimes I will use this, but I'm not religious on it because I don't see the hype in this. I was kind of influenced on TikTok to get this and I don't see the hype at all. So I just like to stick to my hair masks as a conditioner. I feel like I don't really need to condition and apply a hair mask, if that makes sense, because I only wash my hair like once a week. I mask once a week, so I don't really feel the need to add a conditioner as well. And then I'm gonna shave. Also love using coconut oil to shave with. If you haven't tried that, definitely give it a go, especially if you've got really dry skin, dry irritated skin. So I use my, obviously, my Estrid. Absolutely love my Estrid razors. I'm just checking out, I shaved my legs yesterday. That's probably gonna show up all my leg hairs. So sorry about that if you just saw that. But yeah, my Estrid razor and my coconut oil for a really nice, close, smooth, like dolphin skin shave. Absolutely love that combination. What else will I use in the shower? Probably, that'll probably be it. And then when I get out, I'll slather my body in either coconut oil or whatever body butter I'm using at the time. Again, I just like to switch up between these. Usually it's Palmer's cocoa butter. I like the gradual tanning one of that, or I've been loving this one. It is like a sleep one, so I do usually use this after my nighttime showers, but I love the smell of it. It's like a really relaxing scent and I absolutely love neon. So I might slather my body in that, who knows. But yeah, I will update you on the progress. After I've washed my hair as well, I'll show you how I blow dry it and how I curl it and style it. Fresh out the shower, I've just brushed through my hair with my Tangle Teaser, my trusty Tangle Teaser. I've literally had this since second year of uni. When was that? 2017? Whatever the maths is on that, I absolutely love Tangle Teasers. I do think it's time to invest in a fresh one though. And then I use, again, the Coco and Eve Like a Virgin Miracle Hair Elixir. This is great for like detangling your hair. This sounds really addy because I know my hair masks are Coco and Eve and now this is Coco and Eve. I did actually work with them a few months back, I think now, but I do genuinely love their products, which is why I've carried on using them in my hair. And this is just like a multi-purpose hair oil, so it's for like styling. It's also it controls frizz and like adds shine and silkiness, and I think it's also heat protectant as well. Yeah, so it provides heat protectant up to 220 degrees, and it's like got coconut oil and all that kind of good stuff in it. So I find this really helps to detangle my hair when it's like wet and fresh out the shower, because I find that my hair gets so knotty because it's obviously got bleach in it. I do struggle to brush it after I've had a shower, so this combination is what gets me through. Kind of keeping my distance with the camera, I'm not gonna lie, because since I've got out of the shower, I've looked at my face, and obviously I had my skin peel yesterday, so it's been 24 hours now, and like the peeling and the purging starts to happen around 24 to 48 hours after your skin peel, and my chin is just one big whitehead. I'm not gonna go into too much detail, but I've just gone on Amazon and ordered some Dots for Spots, I think it's called, the little pimple patches. I've never used them before because I thought it was quite a gimmicky thing and I didn't want to like do more harm to my skin. But the lady that was doing my skin peel yesterday, she actually recommended them, because I said to her, I really struggle with like the purging of these things, because if I have a whitehead on my face, I have to pop it or pick it. Sorry if this is gross and like icking anyone out, but I just can't walk around with like big juicy whiteheads on my face. I just feel so dirty. I know that's not the case, but I just feel that way, and I feel like if I'm talking to someone, they're just looking at my spot. So she said they're really good. You literally just, you've probably seen them, but they're just tiny little round patches that you can stick on your whitehead, and it basically draws all of the gunk out, and you're left with like a flat, you're left with like a flat spot rather than, well, the spot grows, it dries up, but you're like, it basically I don't know what I'm trying to say, but the inflammation goes down, all the pus comes out, so you're not left with like a big red juicy whopper on your chin. So I'm going to be there for about 10 minutes sticking little dots on all of these spots because there is quite a few. But yeah, I'm just keeping my distance now because I think I'm starting to peel and stuff as well, and it's just not a good look. But anyway, I need to blow dry my hair now, so I thought I'd show you how I do this. I get quite a lot of questions on TikTok about my hair. I've never really been like a pro with like hair and makeup, but as I've got older, I've sort of found my little routines that work for me that I'm really happy with, especially my hair, because as I keep saying, it is bleached, so it can look quite frizzy and dry. And I have like naturally quite kinky hair, so I've kind of found a little blow drying routine that works for me. And the main saviour in that is this blow dry brush. It's got all my hair in it, so excuse that. But it's a Babyliss brush. I don't know what this is called, but I got mine from Boots a couple of years back now, but I literally can't do a blow dry without it. It's got like this ceramic plate and then it's like half bristles, so as you blow dry it like really smooths it out. And this kind of acts like, not like a straightener, but it's kind of like a heated ceramic plate, so it does kind of like smooth everything out, and you can create quite a nice bouncy silky blow dry with this. If I'm going for like a proper bouncy blow dry, I have got other blow drying brushes that are like obviously smaller and give a tighter like bounce, but this is just my everyday one that I tend to use because it keeps my hair nice and smooth, and I curl my hair most times after I've blow dried it anyway, so this is good for just like getting all the flyaways, making it nice and smooth. It like seals all the ends in. So what I usually do is I will just section my hair into four parts using these little crocodile clips, make sure it's all nice and brushed out with my tangle teaser, and then I will usually top up the hair elixir just on the ends so that we've got nicely protected hair from any of the heat. And then I will just rough dry each section until it's about 80 to 90% dry, so it's just a little tiny bit damp, and then I will go in with this. So I'm going to get on with that now and I will show you as I go. Also, I don't know if this goes without saying, but I only sort of realised and started doing this not quite recently, probably in the last few years, but I always just used to blow dry my hair like willy-nilly like that, and I'd always get like sticky up flyaways up here, and like my hair would just be frizzing all over the place. But I always now blow dry down, so each hair is like blown down in that direction, and it really helps, especially like along the part in here when you're trying to get like a smooth silky blow dry. It just seals them all down and like styles them in that direction, which really helps any flyaways. So always blow dry down if that's the kind of style that you're going for. So this is the sort of point where I would start using my blow dry barrel brush. Before I use it, I just like to make sure again that there's no tangles or knots before I go in with this, and I probably separate each quarter of my hair into halves like that and start right at the root, making sure everything's smoothed down. I'll just start right at the root and wrap the hair around like that, and then just blow dry down and pull as you go. Okay, so that is it all done. You can sort of see how shiny and smooth and straight that's gone. Like if I just blow dry my hair roughly, it just goes like a frizz ball. It kind of looks like I've slept in plaits, that kind of vibe. So yeah, that brush just makes it all nice and sleek. And then yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead now and do the same on all four sections of my hair, and then we can curl it together. Okay, so that is my hair all fresh and dried. It feels so much better already. I'm just gonna style it now, because what I tend to do, even though I'm not going anywhere today, is once I've done my hair wash, I'll just style it straight away, and then my curls will usually last me like a few days to a week sometimes if I cool them enough. So I'm just gonna do that now. I always get questions about my curler on TikTok. So I use the Mark Hill Pick and Mix wand, which I absolutely love. I always recommend this to anyone who asks me, because I find it so cool that you can change the barrel. I've turned it on so it's hot, so I'm not going to take it out, but you literally just twist this bit comes out, and you can buy so many different styles of this barrel. I got mine from Boots, but I'm sure you can get it in other places as well. But they do like the clampy crimper ones. They do like the really small. I actually bought that barrel. I don't know if it's in here. Oh, here it is. Just to experiment with my hair. This was like a couple of years ago, but look how tight this barrel is. And it literally gives you like tight perm ringlets. So you literally just twist and click it in. And you can use different barrels. So it's like you're buying multiple different products. And I think this was really reasonably priced. Yeah, I think I only paid about £15 for the handle. And then each barrel, I think, is like £10 to £15, depending on which one you get. This was a couple of years ago, so I don't know if they've gone up a bit. But definitely worth the investment, because, as I say, you can just change the barrel whenever you want. So you've got, like, different options with it. I really want to get, like, the mermaid, like, waver type vibe, handle for this, because I think that's really nice in the summer. Don't know what this barrel's called or if it's got a name, but I'm pretty sure it's just the longest and the widest barrel that they do, or it was at the time that I got it. But yeah, they do so many different styles, so it's definitely worth having a little look if you're in the market for a new curler, because I absolutely love it so much. So yeah, again, I section my hair into four pieces when I'm curling, so I'll just twist it up, clip it, make sure it's nice and brushed, and then I will go in with the Miracle Hair Elixir again, just to protect my ends as much as possible and seal it in and everything like that. I mainly just focus on the very ends though. And then curling wise, I will take like probably about an inch worth of hair. So probably like this big of a piece. Maybe that's a bit too big. Maybe like this much hair. And I always, always brush, brush, brush before I start curling, so it's nice and smooth. And you get like a clean curl. And then get the curling wand and always, always, you probably know this by now, always curl away from your face. So I'll just get the curl up almost as tight as possible, type vibe. And then I always leave like, so yeah, I just put it all the way to the top of the barrel, twist around, try and keep the hair as flat as possible as well. And then I always personally just leave out the bottom like inch of my hair, just so I'm not frying and sizzling the dead split ends at the bottom of my hair. And I quite like the look it gives as well. I'll hold this on for about 10 to 12 seconds. I've not been counting, but give it five more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then I'll just carefully drop the curl into my hand. This is really important if you want the curls to last as long as possible. But people have commented like, how do your curls last so long? Because I've said that I only wash my hair once a week and I have curls for like most of that week, and it's definitely this that helps it. You have to let the curl cool in your hand because it just sets it. So I like to bounce it up and down depending on how much time I've got. If I'm in a rush and I'm curling my hair, I'll just do this and cool it down as quickly as possible for a few seconds. But yeah, just try and cool it as much as you can and then drop it, and then I sort of try and like balance it on my shoulder just while I'm doing the rest of it, so it like kind of has extra time to cool down. And then drop to cool. And that's it. That's literally how I curl my hair. So I'll just go around my whole head doing this, and then I will show you it when it's all done. Okay, so that is all my hair curled. I like to just finish it off by going through with a really wide tooth comb. This one I got in like a set with a hair mask, I think. It's from Hair Gain, but you can get these anywhere. The wider the better, I think, because it just doesn't lose any of the curl. And I always wait until all my curls are completely cooled before doing this. And it just sort of like, I don't know, it kind of just straightens the curls out a bit, so it's not too in your face, but they're still nice and big and bouncy. But yeah, that barrel and that curler is the best for creating like a big bouncy curl, if that's the type of vibe you like. So that is my hair all freshly washed and curled. I like to also, again, how many times do I reapply this? But honestly, it's a godsend because it has so many different uses. You can use it at every step of your styling. So I just like to run a little bit through the ends to like seal it and make it all smooth and shiny. But yeah, I think that's going to round up this little mini glow up. I know I don't look like I've grown up because my skin is getting worse and worse by the minute, but it's all for a good cause, and hopefully once the purging settle down, my skin will be improved. But I hope you've enjoyed this little video. Let me know if you've got any questions about anything that I used. And yeah, if you're not subscribed already, make sure that you are. I hope you have a lovely rest of your day. Thanks so much for watching, and hopefully I will see you in the next video.